sum of a finite and infinite geometric series. So before we go into that, we're going to be developing a formula for the sum of the first n terms of a geometric series. First, let's make sure we know what a geometric series is. It's a sum of numbers, and it has a constant ratio of successive terms. So here is such a sequence right here. And so we notice that if you take 1/2 and divide by 1, you get 1/2. 1/4 divided by 1/2 is 1/2. And 1/8 divided by 1/4 is 1/2. And that's because to get from one term to the other, you're multiplying by 1/2. 1/2 times 1/2 times 1/2. Okay, so we want a sum of the n terms, the first n terms. So we write down in general what the sum is. If you start with your first term A, and then you multiply that by that constant ratio, which is x, and then you multiply the third, you know, to get this third term, you multiply by x again, and you keep on multiplying by x, you'll get this expression right here. The reason why it's n minus 1 is because the first one isn't multiplied by x, so there really are n terms here. There's n minus of one of them that have the x, and one that doesn't, so it adds up to n. But if you use this trick of multiplying through every term of the sequence by x, then it multiplies the a by x, and you get ax plus ax squared plus ax to the third plus the one before this, ax to the n minus one, and then this last one gets hit by the x and becomes this one. Now when you subtract them, Sn minus x times Sn, everything's going to get canceled out. All these terms, this one with this one. And the only thing that's going to be remaining is the A from here, from the first one, and the Ax to the n. And of course it's subtracting because we subtracted them. Then you factor out the a and divide over the 1 minus x that you're going to get from factoring this out. That's what that is. And so you're going to divide the 1 minus x over, and you're going to get this expression right here. So know this for a test, and know the derivation steps, which are just right here. These are the derivation steps. Okay, so here's an example. The series 1 plus 1/2 plus 1/4 plus 1/8. S1. Now we're dealing with capital S1 now. Capital S versus little s. We were calling our sequences Sn before. Now Sn is capital S is for sum. So we're doing a sum of the first term because it's just S1. So we use our formula that we derived. A is 1. So we plug in the 1 there. The x is the 1/2. The x is the constant ratio, which is 1/2. And so you plug everything in. The n is 1 because you're dealing with just the sum of the first term. With, you know. So it's 1 times 1 minus 1/2 to the first over 1 minus 1/2. That equals 1/2 over 1/2, which equals 1, which checks out with being the first term. So that's working so far. S2 is the sum of the first two terms. So we put it in our formula. The A is 1. The x constant ratio is 1/2. This time the n is 2, dividing by the 1 minus x. So you get 1 minus 1/4 over 1/2. Divide those and you get 3/2. And sure enough, the sum of the first two terms is 3/2. So I think you can believe that that's working. Now what about if we go on forever and add up all the terms forever? So we have a sum of an infinite series. So as long as the absolute value of x is less than 1, and you'll see why in a second, then this limit as n goes to infinity of these n sums, see, each one of these is a capital S to the n. The limit of those sums will go to, if long as the absolute value of x is less than 1, then x to the n will go to 0. That's why you have a 0 here. And everything else is constants. So we're just going to end up going to that expression there. So 1 plus 1/2 plus 1/4 plus 1/8 all adds up to a over 1 minus x, and a is 1, and x constant ratio is 1/2, and adds up to 2. So remember, in a previous video we had the person walking toward the wall, and each step they took, first step they took half the distance to the wall, so they had 1 on the first step. Second step, they had half the distance to the wall, so the total was 3/2. So that's the sum. So the S2 for two steps was 3/2. So going that way, so on and so forth, we're going to get that same series as this. And so that all adds up to 2, meaning that by the time you walked doing that all the way infinite amount of steps, it'll converge on you hitting the wall. Of course, you're never going to get there because you can't take an infinite amount of steps, but in the limit you're going to reach 2 feet, which is exactly how far it is from you to the wall.